the New Indian Express News Desk. I am Harshita Nagpal. Police has beefed up security in Tirupati as farmers under the leadership of Amravati Parirakshana Samiti are all set to hold a public meeting tomorrow. The meeting was planned as part of the valedictory by the farmers who took part in the 45-day Nyayasthanam to Devasthanam Padayatra, demanding Amravati be retained as the sole capital of Andhra Pradesh. Opposition leader and TDP chief N. Chandrababu Naidu and BJP AP veteran leader Kanna Lakshmi Narayana and other key leaders from CPI will be in attendance. This will also be the first time Chandrababu Naidu will share stage with BJP leader Kanna Lakshmi Narayana after he broke the alliance in 2019. Janasena chief Pawan Kalyan is also likely to attend the meeting. Following the High Court's directions, the farmers will have to conduct the meeting from 1 p.m. to 6 p.m. in strict adherence to protocol. The Andhra Pradesh High Court on Wednesday gave conditional permission to the Amravati farmers to conduct the public meeting in the temple town as they had planned. The farmers had approached the High Court after Tirupati Urban Police refused to grant them permission for holding the meeting, stating that it could lead to law and order problems as the leaders of Rayalaseema Intellectual Forum had also sought approval to hold a meeting in Tirupati the same day in support of the three capitals proposal of the YSR Congress government. On the other hand, a large number of college students, youngsters and members of the Rayalaseema Intellectual Forum took out a huge rally in support of the three capitals in Tirupati city this morning. Gandhi Road in the city reverberated with slogans demanding the state government to set up a high court complex in Kurnool and develop three capitals. Now the standoff between employee unions and the state government continues, with Sajjala Ramakrishna Reddy reiterating that a 34% fitment rate is not possible, keeping in mind the financial situation of the state. Finance Minister Bugana Rajendranath and advisor to the state government Sajjala Ramakrishna Reddy called on Chief Minister Vice Jagannathan Reddy and briefed him about the progress of talks with the employee leaders on the Pay Revision Commission recommendations. The Finance Minister and Chief Secretary also held talks with the Employees Association leaders today. Crop in 11,368 hectares of Chittoor district was damaged due to the heavy rains and the subsequent floods that lashed the region between November 18 and 20. The District Agriculture Department has completed its survey and sent the report to the state government. The report stated that over 36,295 farmers incurred a total crop loss of 17.29 crore rupees. According to the report, crops such as paddy, groundnut, ragi, sugarcane, red gram and maize have been affected in large quantities. It also showed that the incessant rains and floods have inundated 440 hectares of farmlands belonging to 1,274 farmers. About 236 hectares of fields have seen rain splash erosion. A delegation of the e-commerce platform Flipkart, led by CEO Kalyan Krishnamurthy, called on Chief Minister Vice Jagannathan Reddy in Tadepalli today. The company expressed interest to invest in Vizag and offered to create several employment opportunities in the state. Jagan explained to them about the launch of Raitu Bharosa Kendras and urged them to help farmers get better prices for their crops. In other news, tourist boat operations to Papi Hills from Pochavaram in West Godavari district will commence from December 18, benefiting travel enthusiasts from Khammam and Kottagudam districts in Telangana. With that, it's a wrap. Do follow us on Twitter, Instagram and YouTube and download the New Indian Express app for more news and updates.